Hello everyone. So up to now we are discussing different manner of circuits that should be operated under low power category. So already we seen different functionalities. So that should be implemented under VLSI technology. So whatever the circuit designed under VLSI, so we have to operate that circuit in low power. So we have to face so many challenges. Those are nothing but, so first of all, so whatever the designed circuit should be operated under low power. So to operate the low power, so we have to concentrate on different sources of power dissipation. That means in what way we are designed that circuit, so how many sub blocks will be consisting in a specific IC, so that sub blocks will be how many components or how many molecules and how many atoms will be placed in that circuit. So based on those parameters, so that should that IC will consume a different manner of power dissipation. So we have to concentrate mainly the sources of power dissipation. Oh, Prasad, Mogili. Oh, Mogili. Prasad, mute lo kello.
Sir, me dekhe control on sir, me bete sir.
ఇక్కడ మళ్ళీ బ్యాక్ వెళ్ళి అంతా వెళ్ళాలి. So we have to operate those circuits under low power category. We have to concentrate mainly the sources of power dissipation. So where the devices will consuming more power. So whenever that will, the circuit will consumes the more power, so that will be due to with some of the short channel effects within the circuit and some of the glitches and also some of the switching activities that should be takes place in that circuit. So those factors are we have to minimize different type of power dissipation for that circuit. So we have to follow some of the techniques. Those are nothing but so in the last unit we have seen some of the scaling factor and also some of the architectural concepts. So to control the different parameters or different variables present within the circuit. So in this circuit, so mainly we are concentrating on how that low power will be developed. By using a specific circuit when we are maintaining a switched capacitance minimization. So due to the capacitance value is also varies from one level to another level. So definitely the power consumption of the circuit will be increases. So to control the switching capacitance of a specific IC, so we have also reduced the switching activity of different components will be induced or different sub blocks. That will be takes place within the circuit. So here to reduce that switching activity, so we have to follow by proper choice of logic topology, a specific logic topology,
and also we have to follow circuit level optimization. So these specific types, so that will be controlled a specific activity by using a specific data that can have significant impact on the switching activity at the system level. That means we are for inputs we are using the digital data, so the digital data will process from the input to output. So based on different combinations of inputs, so that will be at the system level we have to use one coding rather than the another coding. So which one is the best one to process that digital data? For for this case, for to control the switching activity, so we have to use a gray coding instead of binary coding in applications where data bits change sequentially. So the changing sequential data bits, we can call it as the address bits of specific organization or specific application. So in this case, so we have wherever we have to reduce a specific reduce the switching activity, whenever we are reducing this switching activity, so that will drastically decreases the dynamic power dissipation of the circuit, So whenever that will the circuit operated under a low dynamic power dissipation, so definitely exactly that circuit will operate under the category of low power. So for maintaining the system level approaches, so we have to use both hardware and software co-design circuits, so wherever we have to use the specific level optimization of the circuit. So in case of the low power, so in that low level optimization category, so mainly we have to use different processor techniques. Those are nothing but that will definitely reduces the glitches in the circuit. So whenever we are observing this circuit, so why the power dissipation increasing means so that circuit will introduce or that circuits fall into different type of voltage variation within the whatever the atoms and the molecules involved in the mass circuit, metal oxide semiconductor circuit. So that means whenever the channel variations and the resistance variation in between the source and drain, so due to the variation of those parameters, so simply internally the circuit introduce some of the glitches and the power supply variations within the circuit. So due to that reasons, and also that will also introduce the short channel effects. So due to that reason, mainly the circuit based on these reasons, the circuit dissipate. That means dissipate mainly in view of power. In view of power, that means the power dissipation of the circuit will increases. So whenever the power dissipation of the circuit increases, so the heat generated within the IC, that will also drastically or exponentially increases. So whenever the heat and the power increases, so that circuit does not fulfill that application or that functionality of the circuit. That functionality, so due to that reason, so simply that will be that IC may be burn out, or that IC may be spoils the entire operation, or entire parameters, or entire interconnections will be connected to will be whatever that IC may out of control with the processor. That IC may out of control with the processor. So to overcome those problems, so we have to maintain software and software hardware co-design to control those parameters. So here some of the glitch reduction. So we have some, whenever we have to increase the number of gates or the number of inputs, so definitely the glitches will introduce at the output of that circuit. So here we are using the three AND gates, simple AND gates. So that will be uses. So whenever here we use two and the inputs are two, another one two, and another one two. So four inputs. So we have four combination, but here we have only two devices that will be used. This one is the simplified factor. So in this first category in XOR gate, so that glitches are more. Whenever the formation of the glitches in more in case of left side of the circuit, and in right side of the circuit, so we have to balance the delay between one device output to the another device output. So when we are maintaining this type of structure, so that will does not maintain introduce glitches in the second category of the circuit. So to whenever that does not introduce the glitches, so the power dissipation of the circuit will becomes very low. So whenever the power dissipation of the circuit becomes low, so that will circuit will operate under low power category. Low power category, so that effectively works effectively fulfills the operation of the circuit. And here the whatever we are seeing the same circuit, so that will perform the same functionality, but in case of left hand side diagram, so that will consumes the more power compared with right hand side diagram. So and also that will introduce the glitches, and due to the glitches the delay will be increases, and if the delay increases the consumption of the power is also increases. So to reduce the glitch terms or the glitch factors in the circuit, so we have go for this type of arrangement. This right side diagram we have to follow to operate under low power. So for this we have to use some of the gated clock signals also used for to reduce the power dissipation. And for this one we have some processor, so it is this processor it will be operated with a very high performance. And also even though that will be performed high performance, whenever we use this type of arrangement, that means clock signal and A and B, some of the resistors and the comparator, and most significant comparator. So in this conventional approach, so we have to consider the all bits are latched into whatever we are using the resistors in this circuit, and that resistors are subsequently give the input to the different type of comparators. So by following this arrangement, so the circuit will consuming very low power. So this type of arrangement will implemented in lieu of hardware software hybrid. So here we have to combine both this hardware with a specific software that will be that specific software may have that fulfills these functionality, that means floating point addition and the addition functionality and loading category and the branch if carry lead, and it will also have an extra hardware, that is arithmetic logic unit, so that have that will performs some of the functionalities. Those are nothing but a floating point unit, and the for loading and the storing purpose we have to use another unit, and also to maintain a specific branch of we have maintain specific branch of instructions within a branch unit. So those are all will performed with a specific hardware and software co-design. So that by maintaining that hardware and software co-design, so we have to we use a specific engine that is a very long instruction word engine. So to have that engine, so that will be that processor with that will operates with two integer units. That is nothing but a floating point unit and the memory unit. So these units and branch units, so whatever the VLSI very long instruction word. So in this instruction word, so we have to use different molecules to perform the VLSI operation, to perform the operations. That means very large scale integration operations. So that will be performed with the help of the molecules. So the conclusion of the topic is, so whenever we are maintaining proper gated clock signals and this type of software and hardware co-design and the switched capacitance techniques, minimum switched capacitance techniques, and also scaling factors. So these are all techniques will control our that will controls the power dissipation of the individual parts placed within the IC, whatever the individual components. So those are that may be implemented with help of the molecules and the atoms within the VLSI chip, within the VLSI chip. So that should be controlled. So we have to follow some of the techniques that is nothing but minimizing the switched capacitance between one atom to another atom, or one channel to another channel. So whenever we are minimizing that capacitance values, so definitely the power dissipation of the circuit will decreases. So for this one, we have to use some of the coding techniques, bus encoding or clock encoding signals. So we have to use in the next class, we will clearly see what is the bus encoding techniques. So in the bus encoding technique, we have gray coding and the one hot coding and bus inversion coding and so clock gating coding. So these are all the topics we'll see in the next class. So this is about some of the techniques we have to use to reduce the glitches, and we have to maintain some of the gated clock signals with the hardware software co-design. So these are all mainly whatever from the third unit we are studying some of the techniques that will be used to control the power dissipation of the circuit. So what are the problems arises within the circuit? So to overcome that problem, so we are following some of the techniques to operate a specific IC under low power. So and we will discuss remaining topics in next class. We will discuss the next topic in next class. So thank you for watching. So we'll meet in next class. Thank you.